Hi everyone, welcome back. In this video, I'm going to show you some useful customizations for the rows and cells of the data grid control. I assume you guys are familiar with creating a Blazor WebAssembly app and adding the Syncfusion data grid component to it. If not, check the video linked in the above card. Let me open an existing example which contains simple data grid code bound to employee data. I will run this example and show you the output. See here, the grid is rendered with the provided employee data. Now I will show you how to display HTML tags in a data grid's header and content. To do this, I need to enable the disable HTML encode property. First, I add the span tag inside the first name column header and in one of its content. Look here, the span tag is displayed along with the grid data. So I set a disable HTML encode property to false. Check the grid now, HTML code is disabled in first name column header and its data. Let's see how to customize the grid cells using the query cell info event. Here I'm going to customize the title column data. I had a grid event stack with a T value of employee. Then I had a query cell info event and assign a callback method customize cell. Inside this method, depending on title value, I add classes to highlight the sales representative and others. At last, I define the background colors for these classes. Check the grid and the data of title column is customized based on the background color specified. Next, I'll show you how to auto wrap the cell content of a data grid when it exceeds the column boundary width. The three built-in options available are header, content, and both. Both is the default option which wraps both the header and content. So I add two additional columns, address and email, to demonstrate this feature. Look at the grid, a part of a column header, employee address, and its data has been hidden. To wrap the cell content, I enable the allow text wrap property. Looking at the grid, both the header and content of the employee address column are wrapped. If I want to wrap only the header, then I add a grid text wrap settings tag and set its wrap mode to header. If you check the grid now, only the header content is wrapped. Then let me change the wrap mode to content. Here you can see only the grid content is wrapped. I can also customize the data grid lines using the grid lines property. The available grid line options are horizontal, vertical, both, none, and default. For better understanding, I comment out the previous customizations. I add the grid lines property to the data grid and set its value to both. Check the output with the grid line option as both. Check the grid with option as none, horizontal, vertical, and default. And this one displays data grid lines based on the theme. Next, I'll show you the different clip modes, clip, ellipsis, and ellipsis with tooltip. So far, we have seen the default ellipsis mode, which displays ellipsis when the cell content overflows its area. I set the ellipsis with the tooltip option for the address column and the clip option for the employee email ID column. Check the grid, the employee email ID column is displayed with a clip mode which truncates the cell content when it overflows its area, and an ellipsis with a tooltip is shown for the address column. Now I'll show you how to customize the cell data using the custom attributes property. Here I add the class E attribute for the employee ID column using the custom attributes property. Then I set the background color in the styles. If we check the grid, the provided color is applied to the employee ID column. Finally, I'll show you how to customize rows by using the row data bound event. This event will be triggered for every row in a grid. Now I add the row data bound event and assign the callback method customize row. Inside this method, I had background color for the row that has the title as sales manager with a class eSales and add the class eOthers for the other titles. checking the grid, the rules highlighted based on the specified background color. So that's it. Now let me quickly recap what we have seen in this video. I showed you how to customize grid rows and their cells with some useful options. I also showed you the different data grid lines and clip modes available in the data grid. You can download a working example from the GitHub link in the description for this video below. You can also see about getting a free license key to use our Blazor products if you are eligible for our community license. Thank you for watching this video. If you found this video useful, give it a like and subscribe to our channel. Thank you.